Hi, I'm Dr. Steve Graves from the Department of Geography at Cal State Northridge, and this is the first in a series of videos designed to introduce you to the virtual software lab and to a software called ArcMap GIS housed on the servers here at Cal State Northridge. This video tutorial assumes that you have already managed to install the Citrix client, so we will begin with the assumption you have done that. If you haven't, you need to go back and look at the video tutorial and the instructions on installing the Citrix client. Go to my CSUN software and hit search, and this should come up. I highly recommend that you use, at least in 2015, Microsoft Explorer. It seems to give the VSL the least trouble. Once you're on this page, click on My CSUN software login page, and this page will appear. You type in your username, I'll type in mine. Click login. We're going to try this folder, ArcGIS 10.3. Added newly in 2015. If it doesn't appear this way, the old one, if it's still there, you may use that as well. They should both work. Click, double click, click allow. At the bottom of the page, click open or launch in other browsers. Wait a moment. It may be as much as 60 seconds. You will begin to receive security warnings asking you if it is okay for your computer to connect to the server at CSUN. If you trust CSUN, click Permit Use. And eventually a page similar to this should appear. At least for the first time, you will have a blank page, so click cancel. Click on the open folder. When this open window appears, click on computer. Double click on GeoG Share Drive, H, should appear in your window. If it doesn't, stop now and contact your instructor. Double click on Geography 102 folder, double click on Introduction folder, and double click on the Measurement Project. This window will appear as such. And the first part of the lab requires you to familiarize yourself with the basics of this software. Note that the window here is called the map window. This window on the left is the table of contents window. In the table of content window are three layers of data. You may activate them or turn them on by clicking on and off. You should do that. All has disappeared. The base map. Sometimes it takes a little time to load. I may pause. And so there's a base map. But let's go back to the original formula or the original view. There's a zoom in tool. There is a pan tool. You may zoom out. These arrows allow you to go backwards and forwards to previous views. And the globe icon will zoom to the original extent. So experiment with those. Okay, so we are back to the full extent. Hopefully that will work well for you. Your first task is to click on the blue information button in the toolbar and move your cursor to the neighborhood known as Chatsworth and click once. A pop-up window will appear that has information about Chatsworth, as it appears in the map. You are to try this and answer a question in Moodle. Another way to get information from this software is to right-click on the layer containing information that you would like to understand or to view. And from the drop-down menu, select Open Attribute Table. What will appear, I'll expand this, is a table of attributes or a data table that's associated with various neighborhoods. You are expected to answer a couple of questions based on that data. Note that when a user highlights data in the attribute table, that the highlight also appears on the map as well. So that's a interesting tool. You can unselect a selection by clicking clear. So take a moment to answer a couple of questions in Moodle about what you've seen here. This concludes the very first segment of this video series.